What's happening out there, everyone? It's Rolleezy here, and I'm back with another GTA 5 online video. In today's video, I will be showing you guys one of the most important things to have in your special vehicle warehouse if you are a glitcher, you know, if you do money glitches and stuff. You want to go ahead and put an LG Retro Custom in your special vehicle warehouse. Some of you might be asking why. Reason is, you have no cooldown when calling that vehicle. Now, if it blows up, then you have a cooldown, but as long as it doesn't blow up, you can just keep calling it out every time and keep doing these dupe glitches back to back, you know, without having to call your mechanic. And it's way faster to actually call them from the special vehicle warehouse. Now, not only can you put a, there's a few requirements of this, just so you know, but not only can you put a retro in your special vehicle warehouse, but you can also put like aircraft. You can put a Hydra in there if you want, so you have no cooldown. You can call that, it'll spawn right next to you on the street, you know, a buzzard, whatever you want. But this video will be aimed towards putting a retro in there for the money glitchers, okay? That's why I wanted to make this. All right, so apart from that, we're gonna be going over, like, I'll put a text tutorial in the description and in the pinned comment on how to actually do aircrafts if you really want that. But right now, we're just focusing on how to put the retro in the special vehicle warehouse. So what you wanna do is you wanna actually go into a public session, okay? First, and this is obviously if you don't have a special vehicle warehouse yet. I'm showing you straight up from the beginning what you gotta do. So go into a public session and then go to your CEO office. Go over to your CEO computer, sign in, and then once you're in the computer, you're gonna go over to the vehicle cargo menu, okay? So you see vehicle cargo right there? That's actually where you go to purchase an actual special vehicle warehouse. You need this, you know, right here to do the source missions and all that, but it has the underground garage for special vehicles. So what you need to do is actually buy this first. If you look on the warehouse map, this is actually the cheapest one, which is all the way over here. It's at $1.5 million. This is not cheap to do this. You need a lot of stuff, all right? And I'm going over all of that in the video, all right? One by one. I'm not putting it all in the beginning. It's kind of really overwhelming because I'm going to show you anyways. So once you have that purchase, you actually do need some sort of special vehicle in it as well. So the cheapest one is the Wastelander, all right? And I'm going to show you where to buy that right now. When you open up your phone and you go to the internet, you want to go ahead and head over to the Warstock page, which is that sponsored advertisement right there in the middle, all right? Once you go ahead and click on the Warstock page, just scroll down. Once I get there, I'm not sure what I was doing right here, but yeah, so you scroll down and you want to go ahead and find the Wastelander, all right? The Wastelander is the cheapest at $658,000. Right now it says not sold because I already bought one before, but yeah, so what I'm actually going to end up buying to do this glitch is the second cheapest, which is still pretty expensive, $1.75 million for the Blazer Aqua, okay? That's another special vehicle that goes into the warehouse. All right, so now that I've bought that, I can actually go into a closed friend session. So sign into a closed friend session, and you need a friend to do this. I'll tell you that right now, but you need a friend to help you out with this glitch. So once you do that, go into a closed friend session, go ahead and invite your friend in there, make sure he's in there with you. You wanna fill up any garage, all right? Make sure it's completely full, and I'm actually gonna purchase this garage right here because it's next to my facility, okay? So you need a facility, you need an Avenger, you need a friend, you need a garage, you know, you need a lot of stuff for this, okay? But yeah, so right now I have purchased this garage, it's full, but I need to put a retro in there, all right? You're putting the car that you want inside. If you want a Deluxo, you can actually use a Deluxo instead too. Now what I recommend for most dupe glitches, go ahead, and this isn't a dupe glitch, but it's to put it in there for dupe glitches for the future. Go ahead and actually put a custom plate on this car. If you don't have one, you don't have one, but I recommend if you have your plate options, go ahead and just throw a custom plate on this retro before you go ahead and actually put it into the warehouse. So now that I have my custom plate, I'm gonna put this in that full garage, okay? And I picked this garage because it's right next to my facility. That's where we're gonna be getting glitched out. So right now, this retro is in my garage. I have a special vehicle warehouse. There's a special vehicle in it. You know, so I'm almost set up. I'm actually pretty much set up to do the entire glitch, okay? Now in your facility, you need any car. Doesn't really matter what it is. I'd recommend just using an RH8. If you're scared to lose a car, you won't, but just use an RH8, so. I'm gonna go ahead and go into my facility. I have an RH8 in there, I have an Avenger, I have my friend in the session, and we are in a closed friend session, and you're gonna see why. So let me just shout out a few people right here. Shout out to King Alex and EVILBRANCH because we're using their drive-in facility glitch. And also shout out to Macclesfield UK because we're using his method on how to get vehicles into the special vehicle warehouse, okay? So now that I've invited BMX, shout out to him for helping me make this video, I'm gonna go ahead and hop into my Avenger. All right, now BMX is gonna go ahead and hop into the passenger seat right next to me. Wasn't sure what we were doing right here, but Here we go. So now I'm just going to go ahead and press right D-pad, and I'm going to be on the mechanics list, you know, to actually mod the Avenger. So just back out of this menu, and then you should see exit the facility. Hover over that. Now, on Xbox and PlayStation, this both works. You want to hold your pause button, the start button, whatever you want to call it, all right? What brings the pause menu up? You want to hold it, let go, and then quickly tap X on PlayStation, or that'd be A on Xbox, okay? If the pause menu came up, you were too slow, all right? So you want to let go of pause and quickly tap X or A, all right? It's literally like a millisecond after each other. It's like, let go of pause X, let go of pause A, you know, like that, all right? And as you can see right here, I just keep failing and failing, but what you want to see is that right there. Saw how the screen just went blurry? Screen's blurry for me, I'm frozen, and my friend BMX is actually on an infinite black loading screen. Okay, that's what you want to see. It's not that hard, trust me. You guys can get it successfully. It is not hard. So on PlayStation, what you can do is actually start up a recent activity, and you would want to just accept the alert. So get a recent activity that has the Start GTA Online option, okay? And once you hit Start GTA Online, you would get an alert. So you see right here, it'd be this one right here. You would accept that, you would just press that, you'd get an alert, accept it, and you would just go into a brand new session, okay? You guys can skip forward after we restart the game, because I'm going to show you what Xbox guys have to do. Xbox guys, while you're stuck on this screen, we don't have recent activities on Xbox, so you actually have to close your app, okay? Completely close the app. So once you've closed the app, you go ahead and you start it right back up. Okay, start the app right back up. I'm going to fast forward all of this stuff right here, you know, signing into the game and doing all that jazz. Now, once you actually load into the game, you want to join your friend back. Remember how I said you want to be in a closed friend session? You want to go ahead and just join your friend again, okay? So go ahead and I'm going to join BMX because he's in that closed friend session, nice and easy. So now that I'm joining him, I'll be spawning in his session. He's actually going to remain on that black loading screen the entire time. He's still in that session, in the Avenger, on that black loading screen, all right? And I should have said it before, but you know, there's a lot of moving parts to this, but you want to have your spawn location either right outside or in the facility. Either way, if you spawn outside, I'd recommend just going outside even if you spawn in the facility. I'm going to call it my special vehicle. So you see, I'm calling up the Blazer Aqua right now. If you use the Wastelander, you'd be calling up the Wastelander. Now we're going to prepare to overwrite this vehicle, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and just have this vehicle out on the map. You just need it out on the map, that's it. So either your Wastelander or your whatever special vehicle you're overriding. Remember, you lose this special vehicle, but you're replacing it for a retro, okay? So if you notice, I'm going to spawn in, and look, he's actually coming down in the elevator with me. That means he's glitched out in my facility. So if you look over here, he's still in the Avenger. We need to get him off that black screen and back to reality so that he can help us out, all right? So now I'm just gonna simply go ahead and start up a Rockstar created mission. A Titan of a job is the one to do. We use it for almost every glitch. We spawn right in place when we, you know, launch it. It's a great, you know, job to use for glitches. So now I'm gonna go ahead and just send him an invite through the party. Xbox, do the same thing. Just send him an invite, you know, through his gamer tag, the party, whatever you want. Once he accepts it and he says he's on the join alert, and you know, you've confirmed that he says he's on the join alert, tell him to just sit there. What you want to simply do now is just back out of the job, okay? But he needs to be sitting on that alert. Once you've backed out of the job and you're back down, you tell him to accept the alerts. He's going to get the join alert accepted, and then he's also going to get an unable to connect, all right? Tell him to accept that as well. Once he's gotten all those alerts, he's going to spawn right back down in the Avenger in the facility, and he can get out and he can walk around. And there we go. Facility is glitched. He's glitched out in the facility. Keep him in there. Now we can go ahead and overwrite that Blazer Aqua or Wastelander or whatever special vehicle you're using outside. Remember, it must be outside before you do this part, okay? You can go in and out of the facility all you want. Him, he's kind of stuck in there, and it's good because you want him to stay in there. So right now I'm going to go ahead and grab my RH8, all right? Now this could be any vehicle, it doesn't really matter, all right? So I'm grabbing my RH8, I'm gonna hop in, he's gonna tap wire triangle and then hold it, and then I need to pop out of the car before his butt touches that seat. I failed right there. So what should happen is he should slide right over. So I'm gonna wait for the car to start, tell him to go ahead and do it again, tap triangle, hold triangle, and then I'm gonna pop out, and look at that, he slides right over, all right? That's what you wanna do. So now he's gonna go ahead and drive the car over to the railings, and we're gonna do that teleport, you know, little trick. All right, I think 115 Stig was the founder of that, and 7Dopper, so shout out to those guys. Now, what just happened there is he parked the car there, he teleported out, I teleported out, and then back in. All right, now I have a full access to the vehicle. Saw that plate? That plate will change, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and go over to the yellow circle, and we're gonna go ahead and overwrite that Blazer Aqua. Now you guys know this trick. You press A and or X and triangle at the same time on PlayStation. That's A and Y on Xbox at the same time. When you press those, you should get a flicker of you going into that car just like that, and then you'll be going up on the elevator. Once you're at this point, you should spawn outside with the vehicle, and look at that. Before your eyes, the plate just changed right there. This is actually a Blazer Aqua, believe it or not. I know it looks like an RH8, but the game is recognizing this as a Blazer Aqua. So what we're doing now, imagine this is the Blazer Aqua or the Wastelander. We're driving this to this full garage. Remember where I said to put the retro in there? It must be full because we need to get that alert to transfer. So we're going to go ahead and drive this in there, accept the transfer, and then you're going to transfer it with that LG Retro Custom that I said to put in there. Now look, the spot is empty, but if I go to the, you know, thing right there, look at that. Vehicle management says that there's a Blazer Aqua in that spot. So that's all we had to do, guys. That's how you actually get a retro in your special vehicle warehouse. Now you can call this baby up and never have a cooldown, all right? Obviously, if it gets blown up, it has a cooldown, but as long as you don't blow it up and you're in an invite session by yourself or whatever and you're using it for glitches, look at this. You can go straight to request special vehicle and you pick the Blazer Aqua, all right? Or whatever vehicle you overrode it with. And you're gonna see when I requested the Blazer Aqua, the retro is actually gonna spawn out on the street. All right, so there we go, guys. I'll leave steps for putting aircrafts in the special vehicle warehouse. If that's what you want, just look at the pinned comment, but that's gonna be it for me, all right? So my name is Rolleezy. Make sure you subscribe to the channel by pressing that big red button. Turn on post notifications and drop a fat like on this video and the rest of my videos for the freshest and the most informative dope GTA 5 online content. Road to 25,000 subscribers. Peace out, everyone.